the last topic of the lesson. It is refraction of light. Light refraction in a glass slab. So glass slab is a glass material which is in cuboidal shape. It's a rectangular cuboidal shaped body. It is called glass slab. When light is sent through this glass slab, how does the light ray takes refraction and what are the results it's going to produce? So let us understand. First, we try to understand it, then we have a practical activity too to discuss about it. First, observation. So glass slab is a rectangular body. Okay? And towards this glass slab, whenever we incident light ray, what is going to happen? Observe, to refract a light ray, always we need is medium. Here we can clearly see that the light is incident in a medium which is outside glass slab. So outside the glass slab, from it light ray incident means it's mostly, let us assume it A. So the light propagation is from air into glass. Comparing these two, what do we say? Air becomes rarer medium and the glass slab becomes denser medium. So the light is here propagating from rarer medium to denser medium. For this propagation, we know that when light travels from rarer medium to denser medium, this will be the actual part, and the light ray is going to refract towards normal. The light ray bends towards normal. From this observation, we can call this incident ray. And this is I, angle of incidence. And similarly, these terms also we can define. This light ray will be refracted ray. And the angle produced here by the normal is being called
angle of refraction.
Okay, this won't be a problem here. Everything according to the conditions. But after the refraction, what's going to happen, you see, the light ray which refracted inside the glass slab is emitting outside. That means it is coming outside into air again. That means once again there is a change of medium, and this change of medium is like what? From denser medium to rarer medium. So that this refracted ray, when meets the surface of the glass slab, here we can assume one more perpendicular, it is a normal too. At this second normal, the light ray's propagation, whenever we observe, it is from denser to rarer. When light ray bends from denser to rarer, the refraction is going to be away from the normal. Okay? The light ray is bent here due to second refraction. So second refraction is causing this bending moment. So this light ray is called emergent ray. The light ray which is going to bend is called emergent ray. And the angle is produced between normal and emergent ray has been called angle of emergence. It is angle of emergence. And here we have some more definitions. What are they? Angle of deviation. So here actually three definitions we have. First one is angle of deviation. Second is vertical shift. And the third, lateral shift. So three definitions. So first one is angle of deviation. So angle of deviation always in any situation has the same definition. So we are going to take the same definition, that's what we have learned in beginning of this lesson. In very beginning of the lesson, when I explained refraction, there I said the angle produced by actual path of light and refracted ray is being called as angle of deviation. That means when light ray once takes the refraction, the incident ray when stretched straight, these dotted lines are called actual path. Why? It means if there is no change in medium, the light ray actually goes into this path. So that's the real path in which a light ray wants to go. So this is actual path. And this is bent light. The angle produced between the bent path and the light ray can be called angle of deviation. Okay, there is another definition for angle of deviation. See, this is in diffraction definition, this is case of refraction, this is angle of deviation. In case, like this, in the case of glass slab, if multiple refractions are going to happen, here we have two refractions overall. This kind of multiple refractions takes place. How can we calculate this angle of deviation? It's very easy. The alternative definition will produce the angle of deviation. The alternative definition is the angle produced by initial light ray and final light ray is called angle of deviation. But you cannot write this in examination. You just for sake to remember easily, I am going to explain. Then we exam raste okka mark kuda veru rasinde kotestha. So my textual definition there was just before I explained. The angle produced between actual path of light and the refracted ray is called angle of deviation. This is a clear definition you need to write in examination. But to understand angle of deviation, easiest definition is the angle produced by initial light ray and final light ray is being called angle of deviation. So during this complete observation, what is initial light ray? Incident ray. This is the light ray first appears. So from the source it has been produced, and this is the light ray first we are able to see, we are able to notice. So this will be called initial light ray. And what is the final light ray? Emergent ray. After the emergent ray we don't have any another type of light ray. So emergent ray will be called final light ray. Incident ray will be called initial light ray. So between these two light rays, whenever there is an angle produced, that can be called angle of deviation. How can we identify it? Don't worry. We need to extend this incident ray straight in its path. That straight path we can also call actual path. Next, the final light ray means emergent light ray we are already observing here. How are these two lines look each other? these two lines, how are they look each other? Almost parallel. So whatever it is, the angle produced between these two light rays can be called as angle of deviation. So actual part, emergent ray. So why we have chosen emergent ray here means this is the final light ray, actual path corresponds to initial light. So between these two lines the angle produced is been called angle of deviation. Whenever you take a regular glass slab, means a particular rectangular shaped glass slab, if the glass slab is exactly rectangular shape, we can call it regular glass slab. For the regular glass slab, this angle of deviation d value remains 0 degrees. So no need of finding any reason, we can clearly understand since it is the rectangular regular glass slab, the two light rays remain parallel to each other. What's the angle between parallel lines? 0 degrees. That's why angle of deviation 0 degrees. Okay, this is the first definition, angle of deviation. Second definition, vertical shift. This is important one, even it also helps in finding a refractive index, but hard to find its definition. So you want to understand, I can give a small practical observation. So whenever you go outside like hospitals or office, go out, big banks, hospitals, banks, this kind of places, whenever you visit, you can find the barricades made of glass. Glass barricades you can find. So hospitals, outside officials, man, line lo nilabadi untam. మధ్యలో అడ్డంగా ఒక గ్లాస్ ప్లేట్ పెట్టేసి ఉంటారు. యువర్ పోస్ట్ ఆఫీస్ దేర్ ఆల్సో యూ కెన్ అబ్జర్వ్ దిస్. సో వెన్ యూ ట్రై టు సీ ద పర్సన్ హూ ఈజ్ అదర్ సైడ్ త్రూ ద గ్లాస్ స్లాబ్ ఆర్ వితౌట్ గ్లాస్, ఆ గ్లాస్ లో ఉన్నప్పుడు చూసిన చూడడానికి, ఆ గ్లాస్ లేకుండా చూడడానికి మాకు తేడా అబ్జర్వ్ చేస్తాం అనుకోండి, ఒకే పొజిషన్ లో వాళ్ళు కనపడరు. సో ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ నాకు ఎదుగు ఈ అబ్బాయి ఉన్నాడు, వితౌట్ గ్లాస్ చూసామంటే ఈ ప్లేస్ లో కనిపిస్తాడు. ఓకే, మధ్యలో ఒక థిక్ గ్లాస్ అడ్డం పెట్టామనుకో, ఆ అబ్బాయి మెల్లిగా పక్క జరిగిపోయింది, అంటే లేచి పక్క పోయి కూర్చున్నాడా? లేదు. బట్ హీఈస్ ఇన్ ద సేమ్ ప్లేస్, బట్ హిస్ అపియరెన్స్ హ్యాస్ బీన్ షిఫ్టెడ్. దాట్ షిఫ్టింగ్ ఈజ్ గోయింగ్ టు ప్రొడ్యూస్ this kind of two words called vertical shift and lateral shift. So how can we find out that shifting moment? So with a small observation, we are going to draw a line, we are going to draw a vertical line at this point. Perpendicular to this line, at this point, we are going to put a needle. So we are going to put here a needle, vertical line to vertical ga pettas. And next, here, coinciding one edge of the glass slab with the line, coinciding one edge of the glass slab with the line, we keep the glass slab and we observe this needle through the glass slab. We observe this needle through glass. అంటే ఏం చేస్తున్నాం ఇక్కడ? ఒక లైన్ వేస్తాం, వర్టికల్ గా ఒక పిన్ పెట్టాం. నెక్స్ట్ ఈ లైన్ కి కోయిన్సైడ్ తో ఒక గ్లాస్ స్లాబ్. ఇప్పుడు ఆ పిన్ మనం ఎలా చూడాలంటే గ్లాస్ ల్యాబ్ లోంచి చూడాలి, బయట నుంచి చూడకూడదు, ఎయిర్ లోంచి చూడకూడదు, గ్లాస్ ల్యాబ్ లో నుంచి చూడాలి. ఇప్పుడు మనం చేసిన నెక్స్ట్ అబ్జర్వేషన్ ఏంటి? ఇంకొక పిన్ చేసుకుంటాం, we take another pin and place it other side of the line. And if you pin ekkada second pin ekkada undi air lo. Okay, so ipudu oka pin glass lab lo nunchi oka pin air lo nunchi chustha unnam. మనం పెట్టగానే ఏమవుతాయి, రెండు డిఫరెంట్ ప్లేసెస్ లోనే ఉంటాయి, రెండు డిఫరెంట్ డిఫరెంట్ గా కనిపిస్తాయి. మెల్లిగా ఈ ఎయిర్ లో నొప్పిన అలాగే మూవ్ చేస్తారు అనుకో. ఇక్కడ ఉండే పిన్ ఎయిర్ పిన్ మెల్లిగా షిఫ్ట్ చేసుకుంటారు. షిఫ్ట్ చేసుకుంటా షిఫ్ట్ చేసుకుంటా ఏమవుతుందంటే మనకి గ్లాస్ లో నుంచి పిన్ కనిపిస్తుంది కదా, ఈ పిన్ అండ్ ఈ పిన్ రెండు ఒక స్ట్రైట్ లైన్ లో ఉన్నట్టు కనిపిస్తుంది. మనం అలా మూవ్ చేస్తూ వెళ్తుంటే గ్లాస్ లో ఉండే పిన్ రియల్ పిన్, ఎయిర్ లో ఉండే పిన్, దీన్ని మాత్రం మనం మూవ్ చేయట్లా. దిస్ పిన్ వి ఆర్ నాట్ మూవింగ్, బట్ వి ఆర్ వాచింగ్ ఇట్ ఇన్ ఫ్రమ్ గ్లాస్ లా, గ్లాస్ లా నుంచి చూస్తాం. అండ్ అనదర్ వన్ రియల్ పిన్, సెకండ్ పిన్, దీన్ని ఇక్కడ పెట్టి మెల్లిగా షిఫ్ట్ చేస్తా ఉంటే ఏమవుతుంది, మనం ఇక్కడ నుంచి చూసే పిన్ ఇక్కడ షిఫ్ట్ చేసే పిన్ రెండు ఒక స్ట్రైట్ లైన్ లో వస్తాయి. స్ట్రైట్ లైన్ లో వచ్చినాయి కదా, వర్క్స్ ఉన్నాయి కదా అని పిన్ స్లాబ్ పక్కకు తీసామనుకో, ఇది రియల్ గా అయితే పక్కన పక్కన ఉంది. సో మనం గ్లాస్ లో నుంచి చూస్తే రెండు పక్కన పక్కన ఉన్నట్టు కనిపిస్తాయి. గ్లాస్ తీసామనుకో, ఫస్ట్ పిన్ ఒక ప్లేస్, సెకండ్ పిన్ అదే ప్లేస్ ఉంటుంది. అప్పుడు ఈ టూ పిన్స్ కి మధ్యలో డిస్టెన్స్ మెజర్ చేస్తాం. ద డిస్టెన్స్ మెజర్డ్ బిట్వీన్ ద టూ పిన్స్, ఇట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ వర్టికల్ షిఫ్ట్. ఓకే, అండ్ దిస్ ఇస్ సింప్లీ డిఫైన్డ్ యాజ్ ద డిస్టెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ the image and the actual position of a pin, the distance between actual position of image and its image, this will be called as a vertical shift. ఇది మనకి ఇట్లా డెఫినేషన్ చెప్తే ఇప్పటికీ నాకు తెలిసి మీకు అర్థం సగం అర్థమైంది లేదా అసలు అర్థమైపోయింది. You need to and you can understand only in case of an observation of an experiment. Experiment దాన్ని రియల్ గా చేసి చూపిస్తే మీకు బాగా అర్థమవుతుంది. సో దానికి సంబంధించి నా దగ్గర ఒక వీడియో ఉంది, నేను గ్రూప్ లో షేర్ చేపిస్తాను. సో అప్పుడు దెన్ యూ కెన్ అండర్స్టాండ్ వాట్ ఈస్ ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ ద మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ వర్టికల్ షిఫ్ట్ అండ్ యాజ్ ద లేటరల్ షిఫ్ట్. లేటరల్ షిఫ్ట్ నో ప్రాబ్లం, వెరీ ఈజీ టు అండర్స్టాండ్, బట్ ఈస్ నన్నేమర్ ద పర్పెండిక్యులర్ డిస్టెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ యాక్చువల్ పార్ట్ అండ్ ఎమర్జెంట్. లేటరల్ షిఫ్ట్ వెరీ ఈజీ డెఫినేషన్, ద పర్పెండిక్యులర్ డిస్టెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ ఎమర్జెంట్ రే అండ్ యాక్చువల్, దిస్ విల్ బి కాల్డ్ యాజ్ లేటరల్ షిఫ్ట్. సో హార్డ్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ ఈజ్ ఓన్లీ వర్టికల్ డిస్టెన్స్, వర్టికల్ షిఫ్ట్. సో రిలేటెడ్ టు దిస్ వర్టికల్ షిఫ్ట్ ఐ విల్ గివ్ యూ అ వీడియో. There you can observe the complete experiment of this glass lab, and also you can understand the complete meaning of that word vertical shift. Okay, this is it. And next we have a formula in the syllabus. The formula is used to find the refractive index of glass lab. How can we find out this glass lab's refractive index? So the formula. Refractive index is equal to thickness of glass lab by thickness of glass lab minus VS means vertical shift. This condition will give us glass lab's refractive index. So what are the terms we need? We need only two terms: thickness of glass slab and vertical shift. So vertical shift, like this activity, we can find out. But the glass slab thickness can be found by finding the distance between two refracting surfaces. So thickness, you may get doubt. Thickness means what? The glass will be some size. So that size distance we need to find out. That's not one. Here thickness of glass slab means the distance between two surfaces we have chosen for refraction. Okay, and give it a box. So generally, this is a cuboidal shaped body. Observing this cuboidal shaped body, thickness means what we say? This portion will be the thickness. But here thickness means not this portion. Out of this, six faces. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Out of these six faces, which two faces we have chosen for the refraction? Those two faces thickness, with those two faces distance will be called thickness. If light is incident on the this surface, definitely through the other surface it will take emergence. So between these two surfaces, when we measure distance, that will be called thickness. In case we have positioned like this, and incident ray is going to fall on this surface, where does the emergence will be? The bottom surface. So this time, from top surface to bottom surface distance can be called thickness. So thickness should be chosen here according to the surfaces we have chosen for refraction. So this is thickness, and I already explained how to find out the vertical shift. Those two, when we substitute in the equation, we are going to find out the glass slab's refractive index. And finally, we see the experiment, and that completes the lesson. Experiment will be like a same thing, but we need to explain using a proper equipment. So I already in last class I said, whenever we are doing experiment related to light, three are must: drawing board, white paper, drawing sheets. So once again, the three we are going to choose: drawing board. On the surface, we are going to place a white paper. At the four corners, we insert four drawing pins. Next thing, we take the glass slab. Once again, we place the glass slab in the middle of the paper. With the pencil, we draw the boundaries glass slab. So with the pencil, we draw boundaries of a glass slab using a pencil. Okay, just for few seconds, we remove the glass slab. With a scale, we are going to draw a line towards the boundary. Towards the boundary, we draw. And at the same time, we are going to construct a perpendicular. We are going to construct a perpendicular. And this means what? The perpendicular will be normal one. And this line we have drawn making certain angle will be incident ray and produce an angle of incidence I1. So this is initial construction we need to make. The remaining observations we get as a result of what? To get the remaining observations, we are going to take two pins or needles. We are going to take two needles. We place them on this line at different positions like P and Q. We are going to place those needles on this line which is we noted as incident on edge. At the different places we are going to keep, we name them P and Q. Now replace the glass slab. The glass slab we have taken away, now we replace within the boundary and see these two pins from the glass standing other side. Standing from this side, we are going to observe these two pins through the glass. So through the glass we are going to observe. So what's going to happen when these two we are going to see clearly from this side? At exact one position, that two P and Q, they appear in straight. Like what? If the glass slab is not here, along this line when we see Q behind P is going to stand. Now, when glass slab is kept, even the glass slab is kept, from this side whenever we observe, we are going to see the two pins standing like what? Q and Q behind P. Just like P is hiding behind Q. Q and P, దాక్కున్నట్టు ఒకదాని మీద ఒకటి కనిపిస్తాయి ఇక్కడ నుంచి చూస్తే in only one particular position. So when we find that position, along with the position, we are going to take two more pins this side. అవి ఏ పొజిషన్లో కనిపించాయో అదే పొజిషన్లో మనం ఇక్కడ ఇంకో టూ పిన్స్ పెట్టాం. వీ కెన్ కాల్ ఆర్ ఎస్ పిన్స్ పెట్టేస్తాం అండ్ వీ ప్లాటెడ్ దెమ్ ఆర్ అండ్ ఎస్. నౌ వెన్ ద టూ లైన్స్ వీ హ్యావ్ డ్రాన్, when the two we going to join and draw a line, remove the glass slab. Glass slab pettinte em ayindi? P, Q, R, S, all are in straight line, but by removing the glass slab, P, Q are in one position, R, S are in another position. So after getting the two different positions, whenever we draw a line to combine these two, we get this kind of structure. So PQ line and RS line we are going to draw by after removing the glass line. Now we get this kind of structure. What do we understand from it is, this is the normal. Here we can assume one more normal. What happened as a result means, here to here a refraction happened. From this line to this line there was another refraction. And this definition we have already given, incident ray. Incident ray, angle of incidence. And this will produce angle of refraction. And here as well we can find out like angle like another incidence. This is like another angle of incidence. This one we can call R2. And the finally here, second normal and emergent ray will have angle of emergence. The angle of emergence can be assumed I2. So these are the total angles we are going to find out. And one more thing here, if this glass slab is a regular glass slab, what are the interesting results we are going to get is, angle of incidence I1 equal to angle of emergence I1 is equal to I2. And similarly, angle of refraction, second angle of incidence, R1 is equal to R2. So these are what we are going to prove in this observation. Okay, even through these experiments we can find out thickness of the glass slab, and also we can find out vertical shift. Both values substituting in the equation I have given just before, we can also calculate refractive index. Or otherwise, the incident ray whenever is stretched forward between the incident ray and emergent ray by measuring perpendicular distance, we can also calculate lateral shift. So these are final observations related to the topic refraction of light through glass. So that completes the lesson, and you have some exercises also. Questions may be mostly CC model questions, and you have problems to them. I think you can solve the problems. Try to solve yourself, or you are not able to do, I will explain the problems also. I think there is only one problem. It's a big problem. Maybe you feel difficult. Except that all the problems are simple problems. So you try to solve the textual problems also. But only the difficult problem will be in the black, yellow table. Yellowish table was there at the end of the lesson. Yellowish table would have children. అందులో ఒక ప్రాబ్లం ఉంటుంది, నంబర్ ఐ డిడ్ నాట్ రిమెంబర్. దెర్ ఇస్ అ బిగ్ ప్రాబ్లం. సిక్స్త్ వన్, అ లైట్ రే ఈజ్ ఇన్సిడెంట్ ఆన్ ఎయిర్ లిక్విడ్ ఇంటర్ఫేస్ అట్ 45 degrees అండ్ ఈజ్ రిఫ్రాక్టెడ్ అట్ 30 degrees. What is the refractive index of the liquid? This portion you can find out using Snell's law. Air liquid interface is given and angle is incident at 45 degrees. Angle of incidence 45 degrees, angle of refraction 30 degrees. So you can find out refractive index without any problem because of I and R, both values are given. You can use Snell's equation. But second portion of the problem is going to be difficult. That is, draw a ray diagram to show the passage of light. Sorry, that's not it. For what angle of incidence will the angle between reflected ray and refracted ray be 90 degrees? So he asked, for what angle of incidence? We need to find out angle of incidence. For which situation? A situation where the light ray takes both reflection and refraction, and the angle between those two light rays will be 90 degrees. So I'm going to solve that. First I, it is a 45 degrees or 30 degrees. Angle of incidence and angle of refraction. And according to the Snell's law, N2 by N1 is equal to sin I by sin R. He asked to find the ratio between the two, that is the relative refractive index. So I will write that N21 is equal to sin I means sin 45 degrees, sin R sin 30 degrees. What is sin 45? 1 by 2. Sin 30, 1 by 2. Now 1 by root 2, 1 by 2 reciprocal, 2 by 1. Getting cancelled, root 2 ones, root 2 root 2s. Then N21 equal to root 2 and it will be 1.414. So this is first portion, is a solution. Next task is what? in this interface, the incident ray for one particular angle of incident ray, the light ray is going to take reflection and as well refraction. The light ray is going to take reflection and refraction, and is said that the angle between reflected ray and refracted ray is 90 degrees. This is what he asked us to find out. For this situation, angle of incidence I is the required. So we have some logics here for the reflection. What do we know about reflection? Angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. So let us assume the required value angle of incidence is I, then what's angle of reflection is also I, because both are same angles. And this portion of the angle is 90 degrees. Now this is refractor ray and this is normal. Between the two, the angle is called angle of refraction. Now along the normal we have three angles. What will be the sum of three angles? 180, because it is a straight angle. So I plus R plus 90 is equal to 180. R we need, we transpose the remainder. 180, 90 transposition minus 90, I transposition minus 90. Then R equal to this difference, 90 minus I. Angle of refraction 90 minus I. Angle of incidence I. And then once again, Snell's law equation from this, N21 equal to sin I by sin R. N21, relative refractive index, we have just measured 1.414. Sin I is I only. Sin R will be 90 minus. Now 1.414 equal to sin I by sin 90 minus I. Have you learned this concept, trigonometry? All silver teacups.
Yes, sir.
So to which quadrant 90 minus I belong to?
First quadrant.
In first quadrant, what are positive?
All are positive.
Okay. And since we have 90, what should sign become? Sign we have already determined. Mere cheptaru ga, first quadrant all positive. Means whatever the result will be positive. Ikkada, if 90 or 270 is the angle, what will be sign is going to become?
Cos.
Now this is what? Plus cos angle is
I.
So plus and upon the sign also. So what's the result? Sine by cos? Sine by cos?
Tan.
Tan equal to 1.414, where I equal to tan inverse of 1.414. That will be answer. Academic textbook lo chuste kachithanga angle value raspetaru. So ee angles manam etla determine chestamante logarithmic table అని ఒక చార్ట్ ఉంటుంది. దాంట్లో నేచురల్ టాంజెంట్స్ ఉంటాయి. లాగర్థమిక్ టేబుల్ యూ కెన్ సెర్చ్ ఇట్ అండ్ దేర్ యూ కెన్ ఫైండ్ నేచురల్ టాంజెంట్స్. ఇన్ నేచురల్ టాంజెంట్స్ ఫర్ విచ్ యాంగిల్ 1.414 ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు, దట్ విల్ బి ద ఆన్సర్. ఇన్ గ్రాఫ్స్ బుక్స్ ఐ థింక్ కనిపించాలనుకుంటా. యాక్చువల్లీ లాగరిథమిక్ టేబుల్ అని సపరేట్ ఒక స్పెసిఫిక్ టేబుల్ ఉంటుంది. ఈవెన్ పబ్లిక్ ఎగ్జామ్స్ లో కూడా మీకు అది ప్రొవైడ్ చేయాలి, కానీ ఇప్పుడు ప్రొవైడ్ చేయడం లేదు. మళ్ళీ ఇవ్వాలి. నేచురల్ టాంజెంట్స్ లాగరిథమ్స్ లాగరిథమ్స్ యాంటీ లాగరిథమ్స్ ఉంటాయి.
అవి కాకుండా ఇంకా చాలా టేబుల్ వాల్యూస్ వస్తాయి నేచురల్ సైన్స్ నేచురల్ కోసైన్స్ నేచురల్ టాంజెంట్స్ వాట్లో నేచురల్ టాంజెంట్స్ మీరు చేసుకోవాల్సి చూసుకోవాల్సి నా దగ్గర టేబుల్ ఒకటి ఉంది తర్వాత ఒకసారి చూసి బుక్ తెచ్చి చూపిస్తాను అవి ఎట్లా మేము చేయాలో కూడా చూస్తాను కానీ మీకు ఫ్యూచర్లో ఆ బుక్ యూజ్ కాకపోవచ్చు బికాజ్ మీకు 10th క్లాస్ వరకే రెస్ట్రిక్షన్స్ ఉండేది ఆఫ్టర్ 10th క్లాస్ యూ కెన్ యూజ్ క్యాల్కులేటర్స్ 10th క్లాస్ వరకు క్యాల్కులేటర్ యూజ్ చేయకూడదు ఎగ్జామ్స్లో అనేసి ఒక రెస్ట్రిక్షన్ ఉంది కాబట్టి మీరు దాని మీద డిపెండ్ కావాల్సి వస్తుంది But after 10th, no problem. You don't have any restrictions. You can use scientific calculators. Scientific calculation is just input just enter what the answer is. Okay?